and Bounty, they were getting you a lot more trouble. Like,
well, he caught me off guard when he started playing on Moral, which is good because there were points where he actually was pushing. But see, this is the problem. The way he would adapt against me, he tried that on Bounty and it didn't work. You can't really push buttons like that against Bounty because of the character that he plays.
Yeah.
You could do that against Jeff because Jeff has no kind of reversals for that. But, yeah. You know,
yeah.
Bounty can't do that. Can't, especially against Aoi. And the way he plays, you can't really go into a button fest because he's going to beat you every time.
Yo, B Bounty has the ultimate flowchart. I don't know what he did. I don't know if it's Tekken training, but for real, it's like it covers every situation so well. And it's like, I need to learn from that.
He whiff punishes you very well. At one point, he even whiff punishes you. I think you did 2kg, if I'm not mistaken. And then his own reaction just low grab. And I was like, oh, good shit.
Yeah, his punishing is really spot on.
Oh, man. Yeah, you're right. I didn't even think about that. But he did blow me a lot on whiff punishing and all that stuff.
Yeah, you would back dash and he would follow up with, I guess, the elbow that she has, that little elbow where she leaps forward. Not leaps, but like lunges forward with her elbow. I believe it's...
Getting hit by that, though, man. It's like, that kind of got... That's kind of shenanigans, you know?
But I can tell you were getting anxious a lot, too. Like, if you just... You could probably won more against him if you just played a little bit more patient. It's like when you had low health, you just went more go for broke. At one point, yeah. You gave him a match. When you just did 7k out the blue, I was like, the fuck? I said, he gave up. I said, he just like, just take it.
There was a couple of times I did 7k on accident, but I think that one, I just did it. I was like, I just... No, it's like, when I do a 7k, I'm trying to send a message. Because when it hits, it's like, oh, I got hit with a 7k, and then you like, calm down. So it's like, I have a purpose of doing it. It's still not a good idea. But that's why,
like, if you ever want to be a momentum killer, just crouch back dash 1k. That's that. If you really want to YOLO, just do that, because 7k is like, yeah, it's fast, but if it gets blocked, forget it.
It's low reward too compared to 1k.
Nah, yeah, you're right, cause it's like 50 damage on counter hit compared to, like,
yeah, it's not even Jackie's almost,
so. What was that?
It's not even Jackie's K flip, so like, just use 1k.
Nah, his is like 70.
Yo, yeah, 70-ish.
His is retarded.
It's combo damage.
But like I always told you, if you ever want to YOLO, YOLO 1K. That's it. That's the best. Because at least, at best, for majority of the cast is PK. That's that. At best, they can just get PK. But 7K, forget it. Especially if they're on point with a launcher, it's a good game.
That's right. I'm going to do that more. Because you would hit me with, oh man, like back dash knee or just like, you know, a bar.
Just walk up knee.
That makes me grit my teeth, like, for real.
Jacko matches were hilarious. I love them. Man, it was really entertaining.
I froze up a lot because it was like, I was missing a lot of things, but that was kind of my fault. Because lag kind of really doesn't matter to me. It's just like, it's... I mean, Jacko's seen me. He's seen me in the Poverty Cup where it was like PowerPoint.
Oh my god.
So it's like, just frames when the lag is not a problem.
Yeah, I got shut up that day. I remember I put all the dots. I was like, yeah, let's see you fucking do this shit. And was that lag, and he did. I was just like,
I'm like, really, huh? Okay, I did it once. And then, like, 2 minutes later, I did it again. Just to show him. It was in the same match.
Like, I can adjust to lag. The only thing, and I take my L's no matter what, but the only thing I can truly say lag hampers me on is my fuzzy punishes with fuzzy knee. Is this high? I see the highs and it's like, oh my god, I'd be like, if this was offline, that would have been free knee. But I just got to go with the flow, had to switch it up. But it kind of did irk me a couple of times where I would just get counter hit out of a duck.
Yeah, like for real, it was like, there was just...
It wasn't that bad though. Like, I might, like if it was like the way it was when you were hosting, yeah, I probably would have probably just fucking threw my stick, but...
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I figured it'd be a little bit better, so I was more content with playing at that speed.
Yeah, it was a lot better when you hosted, so...
Yeah. Oh, okay, that's good. But yeah, I was just wondering about that, so...
Yeah, and I think it affected BG the most, like, for real, because they couldn't... Like, I can tell he's not an online player, like, for real. You know, he'll drop some stuff, and then it was like, he kind of doesn't...
No, he plays online. He's playing. He's been playing online more often, if anything, but it's just...
Yeah, more often, I think, but at the same time, doesn't, like, you have good. I don't think he adjusts as well as like a lot of other people.
That, and I think is also, I do believe the lag did hamper him a bit, but I know knowing him, he wouldn't let that be his crutch. But at the same time, I think he hasn't quite entered the comfort zone versus Sarah yet.
Yeah.
Because I don't, like, even on playing, when he played on PSN, I don't really know, like, what Sarah's he really played. And then he's been playing on Boss more recently, but when you think about it, the only really Sarah players on there are me and you, so, you know.
Yeah, for real. Yo, man, that was the thing with BG. Like, I could tell he didn't know the Sarah matchup as well, and that's like I always promise. He's like, you don't know the matchup, and it's like, oh, she can just do all kinds of stuff. I was doing -2.
Yeah, you were getting away with murder, and I was just like, at that point, I kind of respect BG, so I was like, yeah, I chalk it to the fact that he's just not familiar with the matchup, or quite, he just hasn't entered a comfort zone yet.
He needed to block more, that's what I noticed.
Yeah, he was getting anxious too. I think also he was getting frustrated, because that's what happened with me the first game we played. I kept tech rolling, because that lag was fucking with me mentally, so I just kept tech rolling. I kept getting hit, and I was like, yeah, I need to calm down.
Yeah.
BG, from the first ready go, it was like, well, y'all heard me. It was like that lag.
Yeah, like,
it was like hitting the water from like 2 stories up or something.
Yeah, like,
it was ridiculous.
The majority of, sorry.
Oh, go ahead.
I was gonna say, like, the majority of your wins came against BG, and it was like BG got 2 wins, Jacko got 5, and Bounty got 8. So like
8.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because I flopped on the last one. I forgot what the fuck happened. I think I got low kicked or something. You were using your low kick shenanigans on Bounty on me, and it worked, and I think you just lowed me and I died. Plus that draw mind fucked me and made me laugh. It made me laugh. I was like, what the fuck?
Like,
yeah.
Oh no, like, yo, me. Oh yeah, I'm about to do like a burst of pitch with B Bounty. Like, for real.
So. Yeah, he got 8. It was eight. Let me see. I tallied everything just for fun. So you've got it's 6-2 against BG. Oh, Bounty man. Got 8-1, and I got 5-3.
Wow. Pretty good.
It's not bad. It's not bad at all, actually.
Overall, Blackstar really good score. But if it was just Jacko and BB in the room, and no BG, it would have been a lot more lopsided, I think.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Maybe a Roger that kind of thing.
Could have been. I think at the very end, I finally started adjusting toward
you were
and BB, but it was like a little too late. So, yeah,
it's really hard.
I saw it cost. It was like 7-Eleven or something. I was like, I got to get here.
Yeah, you started being unmoral and started going in with more offense, which was good. And it kind of threw me off a bit for a game. I was like, oh shit, he's actually pushing buttons. Because I kept expecting you to freeze up, and then you started barring. I was like, okay, good. This is what he needs to do. I said, like, because you can't really freeze up too much against Jeffrey, because he has ways to make you stagger or break your guard even. So.
Yeah, he was on the offensive against you, but when he started throwing out the haymakers, like, he'd freeze up. Like, you were throwing a lot of A-makers, like slower moves but big damage.
Yeah. And,
it was good, Joe.
Yo, BG, I'm sorry. I tried to look for your name for like 5 minutes. I was like, it's B something. And it started with a K.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, my God. Delete him.
Yeah, I just stepped on, like, I stepped on the stream probably about like 2 minutes ago just to hear, like, The after game post chat, whatever you would say. So anybody say any external factors, lag, jitters, frustration, anxiety, whatever the case may be. Good games to you. You played really well, and hopefully I get to play you a lot more in the future, because I don't like the way I played at all. It was just horrible. I was getting mollywopped left and right. It was bad. So yeah, definitely.
Yeah. I think it was just like, yo, B-Pot, and you hit like, I don't know, it was the other side. It was like you get smacked in the face with lag, and then you like the drop the. Go ahead. Okay, I guess you gotta do something real quick. But yeah, like for real, it was like opposite ends of the spectrum of luck. So
I don't like to leave matches like this to like that type of factor. You know what I'm saying? Just yeah, don't take anything away from it. Don't add anything to it. You just bought me. It is what it is.
I mean, yeah, you know? It is what it is. But at the same time, it is what it is. It's not like I outsmarted you all the time or something. So
no,
I mean, I took advantage of some ridiculous stuff, and then of course, lag Mingo or whatever. Yo, it made its appearance too. So
those stutter strings, bro. You, I was so close to throwing my stick out of the window.
Damn.
Yo, I was so mad.
That first game I lost, I was about to do that shit. Cause I was like, what the fuck? I can't fuzzy knee, yo. Fuck this game. Like, that's my specialty. That's like, don't whiff throws, don't whiff highs. If I can't knee you out of that, I don't want to play. Like, I'm at a point now where if I can't do my game, I don't want to play. Like,
there's a lot of factors. I can't say it's jitters. After like the first three games or so, I think I got the jitters out of me. Well, lag is a factor, but lag is always a factor. It's online. But it was just a combination of that and just, you know, me not playing the way I was supposed to. I did hear that combo that Jacko said about me not playing Sarah's. Actually, when I was on PlayStation Network, I used to play this Sarah called Toy Dingo.
ATL Sarah, yep.
Yeah, I used to play him all the time. At that time, I really, really knew the Sarah matchup. But, you know, I haven't played really any solid Sarahs in some time consistently. So, like, yeah, there's some matchup knowledge that I am lacking.
It's just comfort zone. I wouldn't even necessarily say a match. Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry, Muffo, I cut you off. But, it is a comfort zone, being comfortable with my opponent. But, you know, as you can see, Blackstar, you know, just up, kept on stutter string, and then, you know, so, I mean, regardless of how comfortable you are or are not with your opponent, there's like a certain style that you have to kind of like conform to until you get comfortable, you know. I'm Akira, I should be super safe all the time until, you know, I start, you know, learning what calculated risk to take, you know, if I have to take it, you know.
But yeah.
At by the time, what was it? We played 8 games. I'd say by like the 4th or 5th game, I pretty much gave up. I was just so angry. You have no idea, bro.
I'm sure, man.
Yo, with Sarah, yo, it's like when I get Flamingo, and I'm like, I see certain things, it's like, okay. You know, okay, I'll tell you the secret to beat Flamingo right now. It's easy. Mm-hmm. It's real easy. Flamingo, with all her options, you do it's a 50-50 that you have to do. It's either 2P or evade. Evade is better. Mm. Don't do...
Oh, but no. Online, evade is not consistent.
True, but still, it's the... What is it? The risks are still less with evade.
I see 2P. What you're saying.
So still, exactly. But yeah, if people are like evading, if they do consistent stuff, like they mash high or something like that, or you do evade... Because you can do evade, evade block, or evade attack. If you do like evade attack, or you mash high, or you counter a lot, or you do, you know, all kinds of crazy stuff, it's like, okay, I get happy then. I do all kinds of crazy mix-ups.
It is, because like, what was another thing that was like, it was pissing me off that I couldn't block? It was Flamingo P2KKK. I couldn't block the first low to save my life. It just wouldn't let me do it. And the other one, I think it's probably like counter hit any Flamingo entry counter hit to that low hit throw. I couldn't block that to save my life either. So it was like, yeah, I don't know. Yeah,
that's the thing is like with that's because usually our best entry is +4. I need +5 to do the low kick for free. I can do that from max distance. That's why I say 2P or evade is really good, because 2P can blow that up. Like, yeah. That's what I'm saying. Sarah is full of smoke and mirrors. She's like full of like fraudulent stuff. But if you don't know it, it's like everything's gonna look amazing. So
I was probably pressing all the wrong buttons except for 2P. All the buttons I possibly could except for 2P. I was like
you needed to press the guard button a bit more.
It's not even that. It's like because people try stuff out and that doesn't work. They get counter hit. That doesn't work. They get counter hit. And then when none of that works, they kind of shut down and guard. And I'm like, okay, you're guarding now. I can do whatever. So, you know, they'll guard, and try to evade, and that's why I'll do the stutter strings. Like KKK, yeah. Flamingo KKK, Stutter K, and stuff like that. Because you think you're safe if you evade, but you have to ECD, you have to do certain things when you evade, otherwise you're going to run into another kick when you think it's over. So, that's an experience thing. It's like a matchup thing.
I'm going to tell you the exact moment when Blasto realized he needs to stop blocking and start pushing buttons. When we had the standoff and he crouched and I just read the crouch and low through it. I know you were pissed.
You talking about Pi stage or whatever?
It was Jean stage, I believe. He was right by the edge of the ring, and I could have just like basically just crouched forward dash and rung you out, but I just stood there and you stood there, so I was like, yo, he's gonna think, yo, my legs, and then you crouched, and the moment you crouched,
yeah, because there was so many moments, and I think it was that match where you knew what I was gonna do. You're like, okay, I'm gonna just troll kick, counter hit in the air.
Like, oh no, troll throw. Oh yeah, neutral threw like three times and you tried to 7K and I just need you.
I'm like, you should have seen my face. I'm like, okay. Oh, I see what you did there. Okay. That's why I was like, go ahead.
And the scary thing about it is just me knowing when. I'm gonna gas myself, you know, it's just knowing when to do it. Because for all I know, I could have just went for another neutral, but at that point, I was like, he's definitely going to push a button now. And it's like, me.
Good read.
And that's what I'm saying. That pisses me off so much because it just makes me look dumb. And I'm like, ugh. Like, I can't.
Honestly, it's not dumb at all. It's legit. Like, that's what the funny thing is. I was like, I know he's pissed, and I know people probably watching and laughing. But if you think about it, that's a legit tactic because I had that plan the entire time. It was just like, I'm gonna throw you because you never woke up kick. Every time you tech rolled, you stood there. So I was like, all right, I'm gonna throw. Because nobody really thinks to break neutral. So I was like, all right, neutral three times. Then he's gonna definitely either duck or push a button. Because if he ducks, I'll still get the knee. If he pushes a button, I'll still get the knee. So at that point, it was just Reed, just like knee. And I got it.
You talking about that one match where you was like, you knocked me down and you did that backbreaker throw or whatever. Knocked me down, backbreaker throw. I'm like, okay, he did it twice. He is going to knee. And I was like, evade. And he did backbreaker throw a third time. And I was like, you know what? Fuck this. I'm going to like push a button. He did knee.
Yeah, he did. At that point, I started noticing. He started going way more fast. Like, good. That's what I want to see. Because, like, you letting me do that is like, come on, son. Like, really, man?
But it's like, who does the same? You know, when there's that, you know, two and then one mix up, right? You know what I mean? Do something twice and then do the next thing once. You did it three times and did it once. And I'm like, who does that? I'm like, who does that? You do me with wake up throw or the okie throw three times. I'm like, who does that?
Woke up, but not even just always just walk up or throw. Cause, yeah. Like, because the thing was, I noticed that you would tech roll in place or you would roll back, but you never did a kick. So I was already, you know, I had my thumb near guard ready to block it, but you never did. So I was like, okay, throw. And then I was like, oh, no buttons, throw. I was like, all right, throw. And then at this point, I was like, there's no way in hell he's going to let me do it a fourth time. No way in hell. So I just took the read and just fucking just pushed the button and knew it would get counted.
Regardless of how salty I was, that made me laugh kind of out loud. And I was like, hold on, knee. Just you see a yellow flash. I'm like, damn, bro.
Like, I almost had two fist holes in my TE stick, like, for real. I'm like, I banged it so hard in my lap, like, for real. Like, I was like, seriously?
Stafford Kelly. Yo, I almost Stafford Kelly tonight. I was really close. Stafford Kelly, just slamming
my stick. Make your own crater.
But going slightly off top, but the Sulfur Kelly incident though was so stupid because it wasn't even like it was any kind of lag or anything. He just made a bad move. He just got fucking like ass kicked by Rico. Rico made a good read and Sulfur got caught and he's just mad. And I'm just like, yo, really? I would just shook his hand and be like, yo, good shit.
Well, that's just him. Yo, Bounty, man. You ain't said nothing, man.
I don't know, I was just listening to everybody, that's all. I was just listening.
How you feel about it, man? How you feel about the set?
Wait, what'd you say?
How you feel about the set?
I think it was pretty good. I mean, I feel like you did really good. And I feel like you did really good, and I just got lucky a lot of times. So I was just trying to stay away from that one KG, and I was just like, oh, that shit aggravates me. I get the shit out of me. So I was just like, you know what, I'm just going to try and back up. I'll be like, you know what, fuck your 1KG. If you want to do that shit, go ahead and do that shit. I'm just gonna back the fuck off. That's what I'm gonna do.
I was like, yes. I think I got blown up by you the first match. It was like some excellent stuff. I'm like, okay, I ain't gonna play Sarah. No, I was like, I know it pisses him off. So I was like, 1KG, 1KG, 1KG. I was like, I know.
That's like me and it worked. I was like, that's new.
No, that
but I backdash 1KG business. I started pissing me off too.
People don't even I don't see why people don't see that. See, that movie is like stupid. And if I know you're gonna press a button, if I know how you're gonna react, I can blow it up too. Like if you do like 2P after that 1KG, I can't really do anything about it. Because on hit is -6, on counter hit is 0, on block is like -14. So you can just 2P and I can't really do anything. But if you do like elbow or some kind of mash or something, I can just do KGK, 1KGK, and then get +8 into whatever I want in Flamingo. So it's like, people get frustrated from getting hit by that so much, and it's like, oh, I'm just gonna do like double palm or elbow or launcher or something, right? So I just do 1KGK, I read it, because that's delayable for forever, so you can't hit check that move. I'm like, okay, you pressing the button? Okay, I do the second kick. And then like counter hit, and then it's just free Flamingo mix up from there. So it's another fraudulent mix up, because once again you can 2P out of that. But
it's not that fraudulent if it works.
That's the thing.
It's working in places which it shouldn't. That's what I'm saying.
That's fraudulent stuff. She's full of that. It's like her stuff works if you allow it to work. And especially your stances, especially like.
Well, if you bring it out the blue and catches somebody off guard, like when you did it to me, because it seemed like a bounty only strat, and then in one of the matches that, for real, because in one of the matches you tried, so let me try this on Jacko, and it worked because I was like, oh shit, and then I thought about it, and I was like, it cost me the game, but I was like, oh, let him do that again because I have 1 PP, a special low, so I could just easily go scoop right under that, under the follow up.
Yeah.
Because I hit a high. I think I tried to jab you or try to 2P. No, I tried to elbow you and you followed up with a K and I got counter hit. And I was like, oh, okay. I see what I have to do now. But, that was good shit regardless. It was a nice little trump card.
Yeah, that's the thing about Jacko knows you got to play with people's emotions. It's like people are people. It's like, I know this is going to piss him off. And when he gets pissed off, I know what he's going to do. He's not going to block, he's going to press a button to get out of the situation. He's gonna want to get out of the situation somehow. So is he gonna evade, or is he gonna barry, or is he gonna counter? It depends on the character and the person. But if I narrow down your choices enough, I know what you're gonna do, and I can blow it up. So
yeah, that was me. I was like, yeah, I just want a turn. Like, can I get a turn, please? Like, that's pretty much like that was pretty much my whole prerogative throughout the like
this is the FSB, last man. FSB is fuck your turn, bro.
And that's the thing. It's like, that's what I want people to think. It's like they think, oh, there's no turn for me to... But there is plenty of chances for you to take a turn. But you just have to know what it is. But if you don't know the matchup, it's just whatever. Might as well just throw it in the air.
Like, you jump the line. Like, that's what... Because you play BF4. That game literally was my turn, your turn, my turn, your turn, right?
Yeah.
This game is literally, and mind you, funny thing is I'm actually quoting Rodney when he said this. And he's absolutely right. He said... FS is basically, my turn, your turn, no, fuck you, it's still my turn. It really is. It really is. It's nuts.
Yeah, for real. Like, yeah, I mean, it is what it is, though. So
yeah, of course, I'm not a complainer. It's just stating the gist of it. It's like, when people don't understand, but that's what you have to understand. You have to be offensive heavy. This game is Tekkenized. It is. It still has some core VF fundamentals, but... It is Tekkenized to a point where you can, you gotta know your whiff punishes, you gotta know your spacing, you gotta know your combos, especially,
Yep. So
you have to do optimal damage, because otherwise, you're giving your opponent an advantage, so to speak.
Yeah. He's gotta go, like, for max damage or, like, next best with, like, good Oki or something.
Yeah.
And that's what was jacking me up. Like, Sarah got so many different... or weight specific combos, and it was like, especially at first, like I'd do like alley combos on Jeffrey, and it's like stuff a whiff. Like,
that's kind of what was cool about it too. I kind of was paying heed to that. I was like, oh yeah, so he's fighting three different weight classes literally. So that's definitely gonna be
that's true.
A hassle.
Yeah, with stuff like, cause like Brad, like Jackie, like Akira, like they don't have to worry about that. It's like you just, well, okay, if you want super max damage, yeah, but if you want to know what's safe that works on everybody, it's like they have universal combos. Like she doesn't have that, except if you wanted some like really low damage, like 51 damage type combos. So it's like I gotta remember that stuff for her. It's like kind of like a requirement.
Oh yeah, I got a combo for you. I noticed you hit me at one point with going to Flamingo. I believe it's either, you know, 8K plus G or 2K plus G. Little the circular.
Yeah.
Counter hit, right?
Yeah.
So when you stand out on a heavyweight, whether it's Jeffrey or Wolf, you do 3K plus G to get a bound, and then you just do 4P plus K and flip kick. All that.
Oh,
combo.
That works.
Mm-hmm.
What? Yo, I gotta test that out.
Cause when I play with Flash or Shang, like I, you know, if I land on them, I just tried it out and I was like, oh shit, this works. What I used to do was I used to do the 3KG bound and then just do, you know, White Women. But I was like, I could probably get more than that.
So White Women?
Yeah, that was the, world famous now.
You could do before the White Women. You know, they fall down fast. So I figured that was like the best thing I could do, but I just experimented when we were playing and it works, you know, the whole thing.
Like, the official name of that move is Where the White Women At.
Where the White Women
At. It was coined by Shiny, I think. So. But the short term, the short
well, that was all
is...
called, that, all that was started by me. It was one day, I think, I just started yelling that out.
And, oh, yeah, okay, it was, yeah, I think it was you. I couldn't remember which one.
It was me. And I think we started that day archive, that infamous day. And it just kind of became a trend. So, I was cool with that.
That's crazy.
But yeah, that combo worked. But yeah, I didn't really get to tackle on your match with Snake Boss. I was like him picking Taco was awkward, but I was noticing that you were just doing PK punishes when you could have just triple P 7K fast input punish. I think if I don't remember the frames. I just know like the movements, but I can't remember the frames. I believe if he's like -15 to negative, I guess like higher than that,
for
you
what?
Could do that string, all three punch in 7K. But if you had to do it really fast, but it all works.
Like as long as he's a minor counter here, right? So it's
So like if he does, I think I forget the belly clap string where he goes.
Yeah.
Like you could do that. Obviously after 20 pistons, you could do it. The little like shoulder ram that he does, the pushy, like I think you can launch it. like I just know the visuals. I don't really know his input, but I just know like what you can do. But I know for the most part, a lot of his shit that you can PK, you can actually do that whole string.
Yeah, exactly.
Like that's what makes Sarah. Because honestly, before I used to think the matchup was horrendous, but it's probably like 5-5 because. While he can hit her pretty hard, he can punish him really hard too. So
exactly,
it makes him scared. It makes Taco players like wary of like what they throw out because they throw out unsafe shit. He can hit hard.
Yeah, so. It's like this one of the matches where both characters hate fighting each other. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, if it's like 6-4 and slightly in his favor or 5-5, but yeah, it's not really that bad, honestly.
I think it's 5-5.
Yeah,
but
fine.
At the same time, it's Taka's game to lose. But at the same time, it's easy for him to lose since everything's punishable. So
I think it's 6-4 for Taka.
I think so too. That just sounds more because it just seems like because you still have two weight gaps between two of his grabs, and he can still get damage easier off of you because you're a lightweight.
True, yeah, she's good at mashing out though. You don't have to take that.
Don't forget, like big part of Sarah's game is a knockdown.
Mm-hmm.
And
yep,
she can't do an elbow knee, she can't do Flamingo P2KKK, and her serpent doesn't work either. And
serpent? Oh, a serpent cannon doesn't knock down
Serpent Taka? Toe kick, the two-hit thing.
Oh, that thing. Oh,
yeah, Dragon Smash Cannon and Serpent Smash Cannon. Dragon Smash Cannon is 1K.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So her knockdown game is nullified a lot.
And, no, it's still there, but you have to... The only way you get it is by punishing him. He has to do something stupid, and then you punish him, and that's your knockdown.
Yeah, but that's the thing. If a Taka player doesn't do anything stupid, then what, you know, like, because the thing is, you can be on the offensive, but you get no reward because you can't really knock him down. You have to play defensive. But then at the same time, he can, you know, his offense is scary. So all he needs is one or two grabs. Basically, he only needs to hit you a total of probably like four times with different mix-ups to kill you. And you can't pick him up or Oki him because, you know, you have your options get shut down by his weight.
That's true. You know?
Don't forget.
Oh, go ahead.
Sorry, I was just going to say, like, you're lightweight too. So he has even max damage combos.
I forgot about that. So
float you to the heavens. So it's definitely 6'4", but you know that's why I said I wish, because like I said, I gotta show you I still have the footage, the videos, like the very, I think it was like version one, like the very first version of.
Oh Africa. Yeah.
Yeah, her freaking just frame kick knocked him back. What else?
They changed some stuff from the revisions.
Well, yeah, that one, that was actually the revision where they had the double bound. So that one, like, yeah.
Oh, that's pretty old.
Yeah, very old. It was just nostalgic because it was just like, damn, if only she had that, the match would have
been agreed.
He would get bopped so bad.
That's probably why he took it out. Like, he got a.
And Shin was strong.
Somehow.
Yeah, it was like.
Shin was strong.
But, I mean, aside from that, though, I mean, you said you played that match well. It was Snake Boss. It was strange that he picked Taka. I felt like he possibly could have won or made it closer if he picked Lau. You know,
he could have. That's what I was waiting on. It was like, because you know, I mean, I messed myself up because I didn't warm up as much as I should, and so I was like playing real respectful, and actually we were both respecting each other a lot because. I think Snake Boss gives me like way too much respect. He's like, "Oh, Black Star." It's like, "Hey, you know, we know you." So I guess he thinks I'm good or something. So he gives me like a lot of respect. Oh, go ahead.
That's kind of like his style. Like he'll like mash and like when it's his turn or something like that, or like I don't know when he's trying to like I don't know put you in a situation and then try to steal the advantage back. He'll mash a lot when it comes down to that. But when he's on defense, he's like on defense. He doesn't press any buttons. He kind of like, you could kind of like throw him, you know.
Yeah.
But Sarah loves that. You don't want to do that against her. He'll get back to death.
So what was the score? Like, what did you?
It was 5-1.
Exactly. So like, yeah. So
it should have been 5-2, 5-3 at least, because if he had picked like Lau or something, even if he had picked Jean, I'd give him Jean too, but. I was like, Taka? I was like, seriously? I can see the strategy behind it, but at the same time, it's just a strategy. It's like, VF takes a little more than that. And you have to execute it, too. He don't know the character that well yet.
His John, I played this John at NYSG. I think you'd have won by the same margin. not trying to disrespect him, but I think the only character he has that would have given you trouble was his Lau, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, I wish he played Lau. That's what I was hoping, but I don't know. Like,
I think,
whatever. And for that, you just had to watch the backdash because he likes to do that backdash little, like rising. I don't even know, like the BBS special, like people call it or something. Like, and and then he hits with that PPB string to like, oh yeah, kick, and like that's pretty much like his game. It's annoying, it's frustrating, but it works.
It's true, but he also the main thing is he don't use Jean stuff. So it's like if you don't use the character's main stuff, it's like why should I be scared? You're just playing like just vanilla, you know, not even a character. You're just playing like a VF kind of. So it's like I don't even know how to describe it, but it's like nondescript, and it's like there's like a lot of the stuff to be scared of is like character specific stuff. So you got Akira with his safeness and his 6 HPs and stuff like that, and his guard break. That's character specific. You got Aoi with her, you know, counters and all that other stuff where you can't play your game. That's character stuff. Same with Flamingo. Plus frames everywhere, character stuff. So if you're not using that, where's your advantage, you know?
His Taka combos were not very good, and he just seems stiff in general. Like,
it's lazy
Taka's not very good.
He's fishing for easy damage and just easy like launchers and knockdown, but you didn't.
He's fishing for an easy win in general.
So. Yeah, that's what Taka does. Taka, the thing about Taka is that you see someone like Shidosha playing and you think, oh, he's easy. Like, nah, Shidosha puts in his work with Taka, man. He knows his character, so it's not. He makes it look like Taka can get like you can make it look that easy when you get to Shidosha's level. Let's put it that way. I'll give him his due props on that.
Yeah.
Like, it's the same thing with Jeff. I'm even gonna credit myself to an extent. It's like when people see me play Jeff, they think that it's easy because they see the damage I land or the wall combos or how I play. It's like, nah. It's nowhere near as easy as I make, or Kamaya even makes it, because it's just like you just have to just know the character. You have to let me actually break it down. It's not just knowing your character, you have to know your opponent.
Yeah.
Tendencies, you have to know habits, you have to pick up on a lot of character and player tendencies, because Jeff can't win without that knowledge. You know, it's not just the knowledge of what can Jeffrey do, you have to have the knowledge of what your opponent and the player can and does do.
I agree.
Yeah, I want to, you know, add to that by saying that, that when you were going against Blackstar, you would use P plus K P entry to threat stance, mm-hmm. and you almost always went for a destruction wave or affliction wave, whatever it's called.
Yeah,
and
he
got hit. He got hit by that like 70% of the time, and like he knew he tried to evade. So it's like, yeah. So like just to be like a testament to what you're saying about that character.
Yeah, no, you're right. So this is like, and that's what makes threat mix-ups work so well. I mean, granted, yeah, threat does suck, and there are ways to shut it down. Yeah, exactly. But if the opponent doesn't know, and you know their tendencies, you can actually use the mix-up to your advantage. So it's like, oh, okay, he likes to evade. Okay, let me KG. He doesn't ECD. Let me KG.
Yeah, that was the
and
big problem.
And block. Let me go for
that
the
guard. That was the thing I was trying to ECD. Okay, I got hit with it 70% of the time. At least 40% of that time I try to ECD.
Oh, I could tell. I'm like, because I still counted his movements. So I was like, either he tried to push a button or he tried to ECD.
Like, I could not. Every time I come across that mix up, I cannot ECD that to say that my life. I try dojo it and all that stuff.
Once you get the timing down, like exactly when to do it, it's really not that hard, but there is a timing involved though. You can't, it's not just do it on impulse and then that's it. You have to really know a sweet spot, right? Because I know Kamaya did it a couple times when we played a while back.
It's actually kind of harder online.
Yeah, like, way harder though. Yeah.
Dojo, I can't do it, no problem. But even I eat it online, even though I know how to do it. And don't forget, if you block on side turn, you can't evade. You'll eat the destruction wave.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense.
A lot of the time, he tried to do it from the side, and that's why I laughed. I was like, I don't think he's ECT'd. And see, it's part of my, that's what they call the Jeffrey Vortex, because the side turn mix up with that, especially if I get you side turn and I go into threat and you don't 2P, it's great, because I think the K plus G keeps you, I think he's plus. It's not zero frames anymore. I think he's like plus three.
It's plus.
Yeah, it's plus.
My ass plus.
Yeah, it's probably like
you try to push a button, and then I can just get a free P plus K mid, because the mid is fast enough to prevent you from pushing buttons. So it keeps you on a block stun. It's not an infinite, but it's, you know, if I can get, I'll guess you every time, I can keep you on the side. Mm-hmm. So it's hard, man. Like that. It's sad. He's a heavyweight, and his damage is not unique, and it's just he has no tools. He's just got to make everything work.
Yeah, he's. I'd say he's like the most honest character, honest VF character, or at least one of the most. I mean, I feel he excels in like a lot of the core things to make you a strong overall VF player, like with spacing, strings, delay strings. I mean, I guess his Oki is pretty good, you know, but like playing the great fundamentals is how you be with him, like how to be good, a great overall VF player. He just doesn't have anything cheap. Like that's pretty much, you know how Akira has his guard breaks. John mm-hmm. could put you knee taku just about anytime he wants. Mm-hmm. Jackie is Jackie. Like yeah, it just
so let's go. Same thing. Like that's why, like, I tell people, like, I don't want to discourage Jeffrey players, like people that are like, you know, people that are listening and stuff. Like I don't want to discourage anybody, but it's just saying like where I'm at with the character now. It took me 2 years to get to that point. Like I'm not gonna say like I just picked him up. I had to go through plenty of trial and error of getting my ass beat by all kinds of people. And, you know, I just kept at it. I never dropped him. So I'm saying if you want to aspire to excel with the character, you can't ever put him aside. You got to always keep playing him no matter what. Through your bad matchups and you're good. You got to stick with him, you know, because it's the moment you put him, because the way I see it is like this: if you want to main Jeff, you got to stick with it. If not, play Go. Because honestly, Go is new age Jeff in this game.
Jeff, you know?
Go has Sabaki's. He has his image, which is Jeffrey-esque. He has Jeff
Freeze. No, it's more than Jeff Freeze. It's more than Jeff Freeze.
Oh, more than well, depending upon which move, but like yeah, for the most part, it's like counter hit knee into 3KP into bread and butter. Yeah, you know his fourth throw was 70. Jeffrey's best throw at forward is 65. What is that?
Why is that? I never understood that either.
Like that's how you know. Like I feel like when Sega did FS, they said this. Yo, let's fuck Jeffrey over. Let's take out all his best tools from Vanilla and R, and let's make him like Dan. Let's make him that character you want to play if you want to challenge yourself or something. It's like, what the fuck?
Even,
oh, man.
Even El Blaze has stronger throw damage. Oh! Forget Go.
Yeah.
El Blaze.
Yeah, like what? Like, this is ridiculous. And it's just like, I don't know, man. I have no idea what they're... I really would love to know what they were thinking, but I hope... Please, Sega, for BF6, make him at least, like, solid or something, you know? Like, don't butcher him where people gotta really work for a win.
Man, they can't make him any worse than now.
Oh,
for BF6.
You say that now, right? And in BF6, he's so bad, I don't even want to play him. I'm a character loyalist, but if he's really bad in 6... Mm-hmm,
yeah.
Go ahead.
If he's nerfed even more, then I'd drop him, probably.
I would, too!
Yeah, yo, the lower on the tier list Jeff is, the happier I am, because I always hated Jeff, all the way from BF1, couldn't stand him, hate him, sorry, but, you know, just had to get that out.
But, yeah. I always thought he was cool.
Nah, I just thought he was just some slobbering, stereotypical black dude, even though he's not black, but,
Right.
It's like, you know, you see a big old black dude with dreads and he's going, and all that stuff. I'm like, really? I'm like,
well,
immediately.
Cool. I think he was probably at his coolest in like BF2. But. Or BF3 even. But then BF4, they just made him real doofy brain dead. Like.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, they really fucked him up. And then 5, he's kind of like a mixture of goofy and cool. Like, he has some cool, like, poses and then. He has some really dumb ones at this, like the fucking saber up his butt.
Oh man!
And
please
fucking,
no.
Yeah, that and even that makes me laugh. And I'm trying to think. He has a couple stupid ones. Like, you see his big ass lips. And I'm like, what the fuck?
Like, man, he wipes his lips like he just ate some church's chicken or something. I'm like, really? I'm like, how much do you want me to hate this character? Like, bro. Yo, like, you straight off a Popeyes commercial.
That man, you said Church's Chicken, too.
Like, for real. Damn, serious.
That chicken, yo. I hate that chicken.
That's what I'm saying. That's why I don't like him. Because of stuff like that. So.
Oh, man. Yeah, that's true. That's true. But.
Alright, so. Y'all got any last words? Because I'm about to put in some Adachi time and Persona. So.
I'll tell you one other thing. I noticed when you do 4K and it staggers, you always do 2K or standing K, and those whiff, you have to do 3K. That is the follow-up to the 4K stagger.
Not always. And the only reason why I'm going to tell you this is because it's weird, and this is something I kind of noticed for myself when I play Sarah, is that depending upon how far they are, it actually whiffs. And Blaster, when we've done a couple of mirrors, I've noticed that.
Yeah.
It's like when I try to, because this is one of the moments I notice it, right? I'll do KP. Blaster will try to 2P me, but I'll 8K, leap, you know, his 2P attempt and get the stat here. At that range, I can't do 3K because he's too far, so I have to do 6KK. It's the only thing that'll be guaranteed and has enough hitbox to hit him.
6KK? Wow, mm-hmm. It works. Like,
yeah,
the only thing I knew that always was guaranteed was 3PK. All the way. No matter what, even the max position, it's always work. But 6KK, that might,
mm-hmm. Yeah, because the
be
knee
even better because okay.
Because I noticed the hitbox for the knees is pretty fucking huge, so the knee will hit, and obviously the K is guaranteed because you know the crumple is like counter hits. You guarantee it's guaranteed.
Yeah, okay. That's what's up. So yeah, I'm looking.
But
at,
no, you're
like,
right. Up close, that's the best strat is obviously 3K. But if you feel like if you start seeing that. When you do a certain move and you go into Flamingo and it whiffs every time you do 3K, just start conditioning yourself to do 6KK.
Yeah, because what I do is like, okay, this is a bad habit.
and this has been going on for forever. Like, I'll do 4K, it staggers, and I do 2K, and it whiffs, of course. That's the worst move you can do in that situation. So what I'm actually doing, I'm not trying to hit you out of stagger with 2K. I'm thinking you're going to block, and that's my next mix-up. That's what it is. I'm not hit confirming, really. So, and that's that's kind of hard to hit confirm to me, but that's just me. But that's what that is. But you're right. That's all I need to do.
This is the visuals. It's like once you get the visuals done and spacing, and you realize, like, okay, when I do that, he or she, whichever character is too far, so let me do 6KK. And it's not bad because you get them, it's a knockdown. So even if they tech roll, you still get your Oki, and if they lay down, you got your momentum. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, y'all 2Ping the crap out of me, too, especially at first. I'm like, yo, this is pissing me off because I'll do, like, high punch and high punch in the mid kick and high punch in the 2K or whatever. And those kind of mixed up. So you're like, nah, 2P, yellow hit, yellow flash. And I was getting pissed off. So I need to do 6K for that. That's what blows that up.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, you're right. You're all right about that. So, but yeah, Bounty, you got any last words about the set?
No, I was just trying to remember what the score was.
The overall score or your score?
No, everybody's score, including Snake Boston's.
His was 5-1.
15-11 for this one.
Oh, shit. You got 8. Okay, so Blackstar got 6-2 BG on BG. You got 8-1 on him, and I got 5-3 on him. So total was 15, the Zawarudo.
Yeah,
and,
11-15.
And then 15-11, yeah.
1-8-1. Oh, I'm so mad at that. Yeah, we gonna have to have another set, BG. And BG and Bounty, we definitely gonna have to have sets, like, for real.
Man, you've words. I can't put my salt into words. I can't articulate my salt right now. It's just
oh, I can sense it.
It's can you?
I know you because we talked long enough and I just like I already know like you don't like when you underperform. Like you're not too hard on yourself, but it comes to a point when you feel like you underperform, you're salty as fuck. You're like, yo, fuck this, like
my god.
But that's not a bad thing. You just have to feed off that and just use that to just be like, yo, I'm gonna fuck this dude up the next time we play. And you most likely will because you're a good player. So
just you know. But I'm like, yeah, all right. I go hard. I'll go hard in dojo or whatever. Like I play all these people. People like, ah, you're a good player. It's all other people or whatever. But when it's time for me to perform, like when I'm on stream, when I want to go to tournament, I get bopped. And that just man, that pisses me off, bro. That's like my main thing right now. I can't compose myself to that point in which, you know, I can perform the way I normally do. And
I feel you. I do.
It is what it is. Like yeah. Me and you tried everything because I'm like, yo, Blackstar is running a train on me right now. Like I have to stop the bleeding. Like I have to compose myself. I'm here listening to music. I'm here just chilling. I'm like, all right, when I get to my match, right, it's going to be a different story. It's going to be a horse of different colors. It's going to be a different story. Get bopped again. And it's like, you have to wait. And the thing is, the salt has time to compound. It has time to because I have to watch two people get wins or somebody who I can't beat right now. And then go get beat all over again just to watch the same two matches, bro. It's like, yo. Yo, the salt was just too much. Like the salt, it was like the Dead Sea salt right there. It was like it's too much.
Oh man, I can understand how I feel, but still, oh man.
I have to hold that pretty much. It is what it is. Yeah, what's up, Kale? What's up?
Like, I thought you played good, but the number one thing is you just didn't block enough, and even when you made good reads, like you evaded the flamingo, you would eat the follow up anyways because you didn't block. So like,
right.
You just need to, I don't know,
familiarize. That's all. That's it.
Yeah.
Like the matches. So this is definitely a good time to archive. You know, hopefully.
it should archive right now.
I'm just fucking with you. So. But I'm pretty sure for everybody.
This should archive, but still, I see what you're saying. I gotta go back. and you know, I gotta watch where it went wrong. And
yeah, because you look and you'll know, you know, let's say you're familiar with like movements, so you'll know, okay, I have to evade to her, whatever, and then you have to, and you'll think of probably like several different follows with Akira when you see it here, like, oh shoot, I could do this and do that, so that's what you gotta do.
Yeah, it is what it is, though. Like, I mean, my advice to you is just like, just how to deal with Flamingo, like I told you. It's real simple. So it's like, once you apply that, then it's all about like experience. I got a bunch of Sarah tricks, but they're tricks, you know. But once you know them, it's just like a magician. That's what playing Sarah is all about. You gotta be a magician. You just gotta make them believe something scary when it's really not.
I believe that I can't. Remember, I do not know the input for that move, but I always call it the "fuck you," where Akira just like basically just uses both his arms, he puts them together, and he just like just lunges them at you.
Oh, Byakko, yo, that's a 13 frame.
Mid. The push.
Yeah.
He
just like.
I see what you're saying. It's P plus K.
Oh, just P plus K. What's the startup on that?
Oh, that move.
18
fast. It seems like
it's 18 frames.
Yeah, move.
Oh, is it? Oh,
yeah.
Crap.
It's slow.
Because a lot of times when I play Cruz sometimes with Sarah and I go into Flamingo, he just does that immediately and it hits me. So it's just like, I don't like, what the fuck? So maybe I just don't push a button. I don't, maybe because I just don't push a button, but sometimes it, as soon as I go into Flamingo, he just does it and it not hits me out of it. I'm like, the fuck?
Sarah's not always, that's not gonna work. You know, it's not gonna work on her.
Yeah, I'm just gonna get like bot. I'm just gonna get stuffed. So it's like,
yeah, I wasn't sure. I was just saying, just try different things. But I guess probably because he just does it, and I get hit before I even do anything.
It's I try to use that move like when I was on his side, try to push him into the wall. He wasn't really having it. He would either like, you know, either like he still had enough. He wasn't at too bad of a disadvantage. We could kind of still 2P where he thought I was going to evade and throw, or he just like blocked or evaded. And like, yeah, when you evade like Akira's stuff, like almost all of his stuff, like 90% of his stuff, you could like either PK or better. So like, you know.
Yeah.
So like when I like try to make a choice, like that's that character too. People like, oh, think like his elbow is godly. Well, his elbow is godly. His 6-6P is godly. But like, you have to like guess. And then you have to guess again, and then you have to guess again. And it's like, if you guess wrong, like if you guess throw, like there's somebody like Jacko, right? You get kneed in your face, and then, you know, whatever, you have to deal with Oki. But like, if I guess wrong you evade me, I'm like heavily punishable. So it's like, it's not always like an immediate thing. It's certain things like should be immediate, but like certain times, sometimes I hesitate with the fear of being punished when I get evaded. So I don't always make the best, you know, the fastest reactions the way I should. So I mean,
you got a freeze rate like me.
Yeah. you should just one of my advices, I guess, and I'm sure you probably heard this many times, is this: I guess you should try to really work on using different moves to condition your opponent to, because the thing was, Blackstar just had momentum on you. The thing is, you're Akira, so you should want to make him be the one that stands still and blocks. You can get that free guard break. Because I feel like, and that's what makes Rodney, like, as simple and basic as he is and boring as fuck, and he'll even admit it. I'm being 100% real. I say this in all due respect. Like, what makes his Akira so effective is he has ways of just, I mean, do the elbow spam, but yeah, it's all conditioning just to get you to keep blocking it so he can get guard break. You know, because he's throwing out the elbows so fast and he's buffering them, and it's like, okay, if I push a button, I'm going to get crumpled, so let me keep blocking. At that point, you're not going to really be able to guess when he's going to guard break you, because before you know it, you're hit, and it's already the stun palm, or, you know, not stun palm, but the palms, 4-6P.
Oh, yeah, and it's I just got like hit one guard break, I was like, nope, never again.
yeah, exactly. So it's just, you have to start using your moves to recondition your opponents and not push buttons. Hence why he does elbow. Because if you're trying to mash against elbow spam, you get super dashing elbow. That's a ready counter hit, you know?
Yeah.
So you do that, and then he realizes, oh shit, I can't push buttons, Kyle. I'm scared of that elbow. He blocks more, guard break. Real simple. I see the strat, and that's why I say it's so simple but so effective. That's why Rodney prospers with Akira in this game.
Oh, but the way to beat Rodney is just like, regardless of how many times he elbows you, keep on 2-ping, and then you get frustrated.
Oh yeah, Rodney is a mental metagame. It's not so much as out. Well, you can outplay him, of course, but with him is once you would get past him mentally, that mental metagame by doing shit that pisses him off like Denkai does, then you can get in. You can open him up way more.
Yeah, but I understand what you're saying though.
Yeah, yeah. Well, not saying copy Rodney. Don't.
Oh, not. Oh, no.
But consider what I'm saying in finding your own rhythm of offense to make your opponent block more, so you can start using Garbrae to your advantage.
Yeah, and
that's really it. Otherwise, you know your shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, you know, it is what it is. Like, man, I think I'm kind of proud of myself because really, I thought I was getting blown up.
Should be.
But yeah, definitely. You played well.
Nah, you did good, man. 15-11 is not bad because, to be honest, I'm thinking the whole time, like, yo, all three of us are going to, like, destroy him.
Yeah.
It really was. And well, then you started changing up smartly on different to each of us and got your wins, like, legit. So, kudos to you on that.
Yeah, okay. Because here's the thing. Yo, no disrespect to Snake Boss, because he did well, too, considering his bad decision with character choice. But at the same time, he did okay. But I was feeling good. I was like, "Yeah, man, I'm all right." And then I play BG, and I get smacked in the face with like Akira stuff. I'm like, "Oh wait, hold up!" Like, yo, BG manhandled me that first round. I had to just like quick. I was like, "Man, these guys ain't playing around. I have to switch up." So it kind of worked out, but yeah, you know,
go ahead. You did really well in that regard too, and like you kind of like, how should I say, exposed like one of my problems, like. Like, let's say, like, I'll try to go at you with everything I have, like, with the force of 1,000 suns. If you repel that and you block it and you send it back to me, I'm kind of like, what? I kind of like mind fuck myself, because it's like, how is he like? He's just like, he's not relenting. He's not reacting the way I should react, the way I think he's gonna react, and like, I kind of second guess myself, and I don't, you know. I waste opportunities. So you were like, oh word, I just got bopped, and you came back and then you turned it up and then what, you beat me like what, 6-2 at like what, 8 games, or was it 9 games, 8 games?
That was 8.
Yeah, so like, yeah, yeah. So it's like, I didn't expect to like 5-0 you or anything like that, but I didn't expect to get 6-2. I was like what is going on right now? But
yeah, I'm surprised it wasn't 15-5, to be honest. That's what I was expecting. I'm like, nah, I gotta turn it up. But it worked out, but still, I want to win
this format. This format, kudos to Shane, because this format actually was a lot better than the individual first two fives.
Yeah,
and yeah.
The
why
I say
fun.
That is,
yeah, this was really fun.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, that's it.
No, you go ahead.
It's really fun. It's really fun. Good.
Yeah, everybody's playing. Everybody's consistent. You know, there's no. Because the thing about it is, when you watch the same two people play, and then you watch another set with the same player playing against them, and then another, it does get a little repetitive and boring. And it gets way more mentally taxing in a sense, because you're already burned out by the first two, and then your last opponent like just gonna scrape you 5-0. At least with this. Because this is the thing, this is how the slam room functions, so to speak. It's, you know, we're competing against each other too. We're on the same team, but we're trying to see which one of us can get the highest, percentage.
Yeah.
So in this case, Bounty beat us both, but he won for us. And Black.
Yo, he beat us both, but like both of our scores combined didn't even match his.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, damn. Like, that's wild.
I'm not quite Dead Sea Salt, but I'm still, like, ridiculous salt level about that 8-1. I'm like...
Get him on level, son. Get him on level.
because I came with a plan. I'm like, okay, Bounty is going to give me a problem. Like, I know how to deal with it. And the thing is, I would deal with it, but I wouldn't respond correctly. So I was like, I would solve the problem, but I'd still... You know, just like doing a math problem. You know the formula, and you saw the problem, but you put on the wrong answer anyway. So that's what happened with me. It's like, okay, I got him conditioned to block low. All I need to do is, like, you know, hit him with launchers and mids now. And it was like, I just kept playing Sarah. And I'm like, why did I? Why?
Well, the thing is, you didn't commit. I noticed that too, actually, and I was actually smirking because I was like, "Oh, you got him to start blocking low now because he started blocking low." Obviously.
Yes, that was my whole goal. I'm like, he's blocking low. He is not countering. He's not yin yanging. He's not, you know, his attack options are limited. So it's like, yeah, I want you to duck. So you're going to duck. I'm going to make you duck. And you don't have to deal with that. So I made him deal with that, and I still didn't. It's like somebody gave me a lottery ticket. I just didn't turn it in, or I turned it in late. That's really what happened. Mm-hmm. So that's why I was
like, he still kept fishing for lows, and he actually started countering them, and he actually started blocking them. So I was just like, stop doing lows, because now he's smart. He's on you, so you need to start doing mids, and you still kept doing lows.
Yep. And doing Ross sweep into block. Like four times, I'm like, oh great, and then I had to start breaking throws, and it didn't work out most times. So,
what mid could Sierra do that can beat Tenchi, like a launcher?
9K.
9K.
That's the only thing.
Yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, I kind of see fast. That
chip. Yeah.
That's 20 frames right there too. So.
It's a bad matchup for Sarah, man.
Yeah, it's terrible.
That shit is honestly, if we were going by Street Fighter numbers, I would say that shit's like 7-3.
I think so. Cool. Like, I'd love to fight Taka any day over Aoi. I hate fighting Aoi.
Who likes fighting Aoi? Let's get that straight.
I do.
I hate it.
Yo, Jeff. Jackal does. He gets to try all kinds of stuff.
Besides Taka, Leon, Jeff. You know, probably like a handful of
characters. Pi's really
good. Probably Blaze. Not too many people like him. I mean, I think obviously I think I may break even with that character, Akira may, but it's not fun either. Like, I can't elbow air to death like I would like to, but
yeah, elbow guard breakers.
Nope. Yeah, because the thing about Jeffrey Aoi and the twist of irony is that Jeffrey forces Aoi to play VF. She can't be Tenchi happy because he has plenty of moves to fuck her up out of that. So she has to commit to I'm serious. She has to commit to fundamentals. It's true.
No, I had that mental visual. You're just doing the headbutt and the headbutt and the headbutt and this counter, blue counter. It's just, that shit makes me laugh so much. But yeah, my bad. Go ahead.
Nah, it's cool. It's cool. But it's like, no, it's true though. Like, you know, like he's just. That's one of the things, and this is a shout out. This is a call out, because people always defend Gun Sniper.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Yep, I'm saying it because I noticed that. I think it was Jami-san on
the Kage.
Yeah, the Kage. He's cool. I have no problems with him really. It's just he says that Gun Sniper told him that the people that he says to play, he apparently beats them on a consistent basis. Now, he's not mentioning names, and I don't know what names he's beaten, but everybody already knows his rep on ranked matches is a dodger. Like, he'll only cherry pick people he can beat, or he'll only play with, like, a circle of people that he can beat. But when it comes to people that beat him, he dodges them. Like, he's played me a couple times, but I noticed when he can't win, he stops. He disappears. He doesn't invite me to a room match or anything. He just doesn't play.
That's what happened to me, like, man. Yeah. I played him like last week. It was like 5 days ago or something like that. And I'm like, yo, Gun Sniper. That was the first time I was on ranked in like, I don't know, like 2 months or something like that. I fought him and I beat him. And in the next match, of course, you know, you lose. You look for that person. And of course, he found me. And then it was like close, I think, or maybe it might have been 3-1 or something like that. But after that, just ghost. I was like, he didn't even show up in the listings.
Yeah,
like, wow,
not even
really?
That. But I'll look, because he's on my friends list, so this is how I know. So, you know, we'll do a couple rank. I see him disappear, so I'm thinking, oh, he's probably going to start a room or ask me to do a PM. He does a room, but I get no invite. So I'm like, well, you just, like, deading me? And, like, really? Because he gets mad, because his Tenchi bullshit does not work on me. Like, don't get me wrong, like, it'll eventually wise up after, like, a couple games and shit, but then I could just readjust, and then he's stuck on limbo again. And it's like, dude, like, really?
Nah, man.
You know?
That dude,
I'll play anybody.
Not,
like, I'm not going to stop playing if you keep eating the same shit. I'm hoping that you're learning from it, but he doesn't.
Yeah, if you're really trying to be the best, you shouldn't turn around anybody except if it's like literally unplayable.
Yeah, that's why people like people like I was salty one day. Like, And I was talking about him. I was like, this guy, like, who the hell is this guy? Whatever. And I talked about him. People's like, people still play him. And I'm like, yeah, regardless, I'm going to play him regardless of how he plays. You know, you just take that as a stepping stone, like your own little metric to how you're progressing, how you're getting better. Mm-hmm. Because he's supposed to be, I mean, like, you know, top players can be anybody, given you know, the right amount of matches, the enough time to read them and see how they play. They could be just about anybody in this country. So it's like, what's the excuse? There's no excuse.
Yeah,
so.
And then, okay, you just hit the nail on the head right there, right? Like, yo, top players, they can beat anybody, right? But they can beat anybody, yo. Like, mid-tier players, is like, they'll call out a player and be like, oh, he's mashy, or he does this all the time, this and that. But you put him in a match with that person, and he might not know exactly how to beat it. Like, okay, that person mashes. They get pissed off and leave and stuff, but they don't know how to... If anything, that should be an opportunity for you to get counter hits and stuff like that. So,
I mean,
to me, there's no reason to get mad. It's because they're giving you a freaking lottery ticket for you to counter hit them and hit them with your biggest stuff. And that should force them to change their game. If you're not doing that, and you're not playing the game right. If you're just getting mad, then what are you doing? You know. So.
I mean, true, but like, you know, I'll go and shoutbox and rage, regardless. So, you know, I know it's my fault. I know I should be a better player, and I need to step my game up. But I'll rage anyway because, you know, I got to get my salt out somehow, and then, and I get back to playing.
It's funny that you mentioned that though with the players playing, because the thing is too, what I was gonna say with Gunstamper and Irony is that a good amount of people that I see that talk shit about him, I don't think can beat him.
I don't think they can beat him.
Just jump on the bandwagon of let's poke fun at him and stuff, because he's not bad. Don't get me wrong, he's not bad. It's just a smart and experienced player can beat him consistently because of his flowchart. But
yeah, he doesn't have a
fuck up. Like that. You can probably fuck up like 60% of people, the shoutbox heroes on VFDC.
Oh yeah.
And say, oh, Gunsniper's this and that. Nah, I feel like if you put him in a set with one of any of those players, he'd beat them.
Yeah, they never show up to set, like, for real.
That cool. Too. But I want him to show up too, because he's kind of telling, saying that he's beating people, and I don't know if he's counting like one or two games, because that doesn't mean shit. But
I
like,
really don't.
I really want to see him like step up and say, "Hey, I'll play this person. I'll play me. I'll play Jacko in the first of 10 and put it on stream or whatever." And I'm like, "All right, man, you step up, you get respect anyway." But I'm gonna beat your ass.
I hope he gets tagged in the Raw thread, man. Because I've been meaning to like try and get other people.
He's on BFDs.
He is. I don't think he posts on there. I don't know if it's a turn off or some. I don't know what the story, but he should be on there. Him, yeah. I've seen his. I think his name is on there.
Oh, you're right, actually.
He's on
Sniper LS.
Like, he's on my friends list. I could just send him a message and just say, "Hey, you want to play like a stream first to 10? I'll actually send him a message like as soon as I see him and just ask him, see what he says.
Yeah.
Cause I mean, like, I'm cool with him. Like, I don't, you know, like we're on like mutual terms. It's not like we're buddy. We play all the time. But if I hit him up, I'm pretty sure he'd be down to play.
Alright, that's what's up.
So I'll ask him.
Okay, like for real, last words. I want to play Persona.
Oh, I'm good.
Before I go to bed. But, no, it's my bad because I was all into it too. So, you know. Okay, so one at a time. Yo, BG, go. Last word.
I'm salty. I'm going to be salty until the next time I play Blackstar. But yeah, great games to Blackstar. Good games to everybody who played. Especially great games to Bounty. Always changing and evolving. Getting better. Yeah. And whenever I play you, Blackstar, it's not going to be the same way.
Okay.
And you're going to get Nah, pretty much. Good games, man.
Whenever, man. Yo, I'm like I've been saying, I've been wanting to play you. I'm so glad I got to play you today, but still, it's like, nah, I just want to play
it's
you.
Like, I played like a, I had like a crappy representation. I mean, whatever. I'm not going to try to make any more excuses or sounds, whatever.
We're going to run it back, though. And it'll be just us. We're going to run it back. So... Or even like just some regular room match or something, we can do that too, or a player match too. So yeah, we got that. So okay, yo, Jacko, words, last word.
Sailor Moon Crystal episode 5, Sailor Jupiter Saturday.
Yo, real, for real?
I should have seen that coming.
Oh man, I didn't know Sailor Jupiter's out about to come out already.
Jeez. Every single link this dude posts on Facebook is about Sailor Moon. This guy.
Dedicated fan.
dedicated fan, bro.
I like how you had that.
Shit, though.
Yeah, like the one where you had the where she had the pillow covers or something with SpongeBob and Squidward or whatever.
I saw that.
Like, I'm gonna go look for that now. No, my favorite.
Oh, that's a good one. Peep that. That should be recent.
When this, I don't know which sailor who was, but some dude just came out of nowhere and tripped on my man and said, "Watch them legs." That was the funniest one.
Oh, that was Mercury. That was my girl.
It's like, "Watch them legs." Did have me rolling, bro.
And she just had to hold it. She couldn't do anything. She hit the car and just was like, "What?" I'm like, "Really? You're just gonna sit there and take that?" He just drove off.
From a flip from like 20 feet away, it came out of nowhere. Trip. Watch them legs.
That's what I'm saying. He did some El Blaze flip. Into like from all across the screen and still tripped her, and then she didn't do anything. I'm like, really?
Mercury got murked.
I'm like, you're smart, but you can't fight apparently. So I don't know.
Oh dude.
All right, yo, Bounty. What you got?
Oh my God, Taylor Mercury. but I'm gonna say good games to Black Star. It was really good, really, really good, really good stuff, like usual. I didn't think it was going to turn out 8-1. I thought it was going to be pretty damn even. So I feel like I still got lucky. But, yeah. And Jacko, can you please give me the link to that Sailor Mercury thing? I could go for a laugh right now.
Man, like, y'all trying to make my girl look bad.
I really want to see it again now.
God, all right, I got you.
Yo, KO, thanks, man. You really saved me.
Yeah, well, it's okay, man. You're commentating really good, man.
Yeah. Was I?
Yeah, you were actually. You were. You know your shit. You know the technical aspect, so you definitely were good.
Yeah.
It's hard to commentate this game as well. So you know you definitely did.
On my own, so.
I don't know how Shirt does that. I don't know how Shirt does.
Oh, he's pretty charismatic. Like, I don't know.
But that is true. Yeah.
That's what it is. So okay, I'm good. You know, that's all I got. Look out for another Raw next week. I don't know what it's gonna be. You know, Snake Boss talking about doing another PSN version of the Slam Room. I'm like, y'all figure that out, and you know, I'll see what y'all come up with.
PSN is going to win that. You can't even. Never mind.
Yeah, PSN's gonna win.
That will never end. This took like 2 hours, like top. Like that would probably take like half a day. Like don't even bother.
Exactly. That's why I'm like, I'll see what y'all come up with.
It probably take like 2 hours, and then y'all just give up. And then, like,
nah, I wouldn't go that far. I already got it in the rules. Third DC set is over. Draw, whatever. I don't care. It's in the rules.
No,
I put it in there for that reason.
PSN wins. Fatality.
Exactly. Because we had some hour and a half long sets, first and tens, whatever, just because PSN kept disconnecting. I'm like, no, just let me stop bringing up bad memories. But yeah, you know, that's what that's going to be about. But yeah, that's all I got. Thanks for coming. All
right, guys. Good games.
All right.
Peace out.
Fellas, easy.
Catch y'all later. Peace.